So today we're going to talk about DFPlayer mini troubleshooting with the Arduino. One of the frustrating things about using the DFPlayer is that it only shows signs of life when it's working fine. The shiny blue light that indicates it's playing audio right here only comes on when everything's perfectly working. So if there's any problems, we have a difficult time knowing if it's even alive. This video is going to talk about some tips to troubleshoot. First, I'll give you a couple general tips. First general tip is to make sure that you have these resistors between your Arduino and your DF player for your RX and your TX. And if you read the spec sheet for the DF player, it says that that helps reduce noise. Sometimes it will fail if you're testing repeatedly. Go ahead and power off and unplug the USB connection every time you're trying to test. This will ensure that it starts up and initializes the Arduino and the DF player properly. And finally, if you're having some issues and it's flaky, you might want to try the 5-volt voltage source. So the DF player has a 3.3 and the DF player input has a 3.3 or 5-volt source it can use. So let's go through a couple scenarios here. The DF player actually has a number of libraries you can use with Arduino. We're going to focus on two here. One is the DFPlayerMiniMp3, and that's a Makuna library. And then the other is DFRobotDFPlayerMini. So what we have is a working example of a DFPlayer connected to the Arduino, and it's just iterating through all of the tracks and saying play finished for. This is the same example that we used in our last video. And if you want to understand how to hook up the connections, check out this other video that we did to hook up the two together. This is the Makuna library. So this is the DFMiniMp3.h. And then also over here, we have the DFRobotDFPlayerMini.h. So I'll show you both libraries and how they react to different scenarios here. So when I run the Makuna, it's just saying play finished for. And when I run the DF player version, we just get kind of number three, number four play finished. So that's if everything goes right. So let's go into what can go wrong here. So first of all, what happens if there's no power to the DF player mini? So what I'm gonna do is go over to my hardware here, and I'll just unplug the power. Okay, so what happens now? So first you can see an error stack wrong. That means that I've lost power. But let's see what error messages come out when it initializes. So this is the DF robot version. And so it's basically giving you the message, you know, unable to begin, please recheck the connection. And if we go over here to the Makuna version, what you get a lot with the Makuna version is zero. So when you start to read the properties, what it does when it in the setup is it does a get software version, get volume, all these will end up being zero. I should unplug it and plug it back in each time. Okay, so if you see here, there's a long delay after starting. So that would be essentially right after the play MP3 folder track. But initializing, I mean, you can tell that you got version 0, volume 0, and it returned immediately. So when it returns immediately with the version and the volume and the files, that could be no power. So then let's go ahead and check. We'll plug it back in. And let's just make sure it comes up. Yep, so it's playing. So the next scenario we can do is, what happens if your RX and TX have some issues? So the first thing I can do on this is, I've got a problem with my RX and TX2. So let me move these over here to RX and TX2. And what we'll do is go into our code and put this on serial 2. And then we'll write this out. And then let me unplug it and plug it back in real quick. Okay, so what's gonna happen now? So what we have is a problem with our RX and TX. Again, we're getting 0000000. And then let's check out what happens on the DF player version. Unplug it and plug it back in here. So it says initializing, unable to begin, check the connection. So these are very generic errors, but essentially it's having trouble. Now, what can we do to see if there's actually a problem with this pin? So the one thing you can do is you can check the pins here with this program, the pin checker. And all it does is it sets the pin to an output and you try to connect an LED to it. So it's just going to do a digital write and then blink an LED off and on. And I'm going to start at pin 13 and go to pin 20. So for the Arduino Mega, that's going to be your RX and TX for 1, 2, and 3 for all those ports. So let's just see if what this does and see if we have any issues, right? Okay, and to do this, what we do is we can bring out... So we're going to test the pins, basically, right? And we can bring out our trusty LED checker. So I'll just pop one in into ground. And let's start at pin 14. Let me turn my light down. Okay, so you can see that the LED is on, then pin 15, LED is on, pin 16, LED is on, pin 17. So I don't have the LED working in this case, so that's actually RX2, and that's why our connection to serial port 2 is not working. And just to go to 18, is working. So anyway, that's just a quick way that we can go ahead and test our ports. So in this particular case, I've blown out the RX2 and TX2. So if you have issues, you might want to change to a different connection port, to like TX3, something like that, and test your ports here. Another thing is regarding power. You can always check on a voltmeter to make sure that you have power between pins 1 and pin 7 on the DF player. So pin 1 and pin 7 should have 5 volts or 3.3 volts. So you can check to see if that's powered up. Now, one other common scenario is you can get the RX and TX mixed up. So let's just reverse these two and see what the behavior is. So I'm just gonna flip the pins between RX and TX. Okay, so now with the pins flipped, let's go ahead and unplug it and plug it back in. And again, you get version 0, volume 0, file 0. Now, one other thing we can test is, what happens if it doesn't find the right files on the DF player? So let's take the chip out. And we'll mount it here. And here's the folder called MP3. Let's just rename it to MP399999. Essentially, it's not gonna find the right files when it starts up. And we'll put the chip back in. Now what happens when we play it? Let's unplug it, plug it back in. Now you see COM error 6. Okay, COM error 6, if you look up the, there's a file called dfplayer constants.h, and it tells you a couple of different error codes, and 0x06 says dfplayer error, no such file. So by looking at COM error 6, you're not gonna see a whole lot. You're not gonna understand a whole lot, but you'll basically understand by looking at the error code that it can't find the MP3 files that it needs. Now let's look at the DFRobot version. So what happens on the DFRobot here? Initializing. Okay, so the DFRobot actually seems to be able to find those files, which is good. So that's interesting. So maybe the next thing we could try is just delete the files altogether. So let's mount the drive again. Okay, so now there's no files, and we will remove the device. We can pop this back in. Now let's see what the DFPlayer library does with no files. Unplug it, plug it back in. Interesting, it still seems to be playing things. That's kind of weird. I think it might be playing out of the deleted files folder. There might be some hidden files out there that it's trying to play off of. Let's check again. Obviously no files on this. Show hidden files. It doesn't seem to have any files here. Let's go on a command line prompt. So you see the trash folder here? Yeah, so this could actually be a huge problem if you have these sort of files on here, because it's gonna look in the trash. Let's go ahead and just remove them. Okay, so now there's no trash. So this should be clean at this point. Let's try and get rid of a bit. Okay, unplug and plug back in. Okay, so now it's basically finding no files, and it just says unable to begin, recheck the connection. So you're back to that generic error. Interesting. Finally, if you have everything working here, the blue light's going, but you still don't have any audio, one thing you want to try is just connect it out of the speakers that it has. So it has an external speaker that you can use if you connect a speaker to pin 6 and pin 8, a little, like a 1-watt speaker, then it will play sound directly without needing an op amp. So you might want to try that. And finally, as a bonus, let me show you a really messed up one. So I have my multimeter here, where if you have a connection, it's just gonna beep. Here's a DF player that I've had, and it's had its own share of problems. If I connect pin 1 and ground, it's actually shorted out. So the funny thing is, when you plug this in to your Arduino, after about 5 seconds, your Arduino overheats and shuts itself down. So hopefully you'll never get into that position, but yes, there can be that too. All right, well, I hope this video helped you if you are troubleshooting your DFPlayer Mini with the Arduino. Sometimes it helps to have a good working version to be able to see what could be, what the behaviors are and what could be wrong with it. So these videos take some time to create, so please like and subscribe to help us grow our little channel.